We believe that within ITC, maximum value creation can come from our investments in the FMCG segment. That is where we have strong enterprise strengths which we can leverage. So going forward, we will not only be investing to strengthen our footprint in existing categories, but we will also over time get into newer categories. Recently, we've gone into juices and we've gone into dairy whitener and ghee, and we've also launched Febel chocolates, a luxury chocolate. We've also gone in with luxury coffee with Sunbean coffee. So over time, you will see us getting into more categories and also strengthening our footprint in existing categories.
As far as the goods and services tax is concerned, we can expect some more stress coming in on the tobacco sector. How are you looking at this? Would you say that you would want to rework your strategy over there as well?
Well, as far as the tobacco sector is concerned, I think that over the last few years, there has been a sharp increase in taxation, which has unfortunately led to a spurt in smuggling. And there is a lot of growth of the illegal segment. So all that taxation has done is that it has created a huge arbitrage opportunity. And today, 1 in 5 cigarettes in the country is smuggled. And it has also led to a shift of consumption from legal cigarettes to illegal and other forms of consumption.
As far as your competitors within the FMCG sector are concerned, we see large players coming in, particularly domestic. We're talking about brands like Patanjali. What will be your strategy when you would deal with them?
The competition is always good for the industry. It's good for the consumer. And we're happy to see people developing Indian brands, because we are likewise also trying to develop global Indian brands.
Is there a revenue target that you'd like to say by 2030 you would want to be a company this big and with this sort of a revenue coming in?
So ITC has already articulated its aspiration to get to 100,000 crores in FMCG by 2030.
Is there a broader strategy that you can tell us again about it?
Well, I have already explained that we will be getting into newer categories, strengthening investments in existing categories. So a combination of that, and we will try to bring to the market innovative, differentiated and first time to the market products. We are also going to have significant investments in the health and wellness space. So we provide products to the consumer which address certain societal concerns today. For example, recently we have launched a sugar control release Atta, which is good for pre-diabetic and diabetic patient. We've also launched an all good digestive, which is the first biscuit which has 0% maida, 0% sugar and no artificial sweetener.